Living off a bubble time, now there is no tomorrow for that guy. The man Akuma Park used to call me Chopper, proper proud of his son, even if he didn't bother to get his act together. He left my grandpappy burying his baby boy. Now that's depressing, I'm fucked up as all hell, but he bore it on himself. And I ain't gonna dwell on the bad times. We used to go hard, doggy through the night on the phone line. I was begging him to sort his life out, but he never did it. I admit it, to be honest, I had given up, didn't really give a shit anymore. And now his body's cold, I hope the afterlife takes care of his soul. All it did was make me angry, till I almost threw my life away as well, doing bad shit. And I realized that sometimes everything is fucked and it's your own fault. The only escape seems like drugs, so I put myself in his shoes. So much to lose and he lost it. What the fuck did you do? What path did you choose? It's a blessing in disguise, cause I called him after 2 years. He told me not to lie, he showed me what was right, not to bury it inside. Coming out in the open, I was definitely crying. It was a long conversation, I'll remember it forever. Like looking into a mirror, a future that I didn't wanna live. I'm his kid and he didn't want me to be like him. A piece of shit, he said that, and that was my dad. In fact, that was the last chin wag we ever had.
Realizes that he won't find it, he will destroy himself.
Hey Reggie, motherfucker, I ain't here. Leave me your message.
I love the fact that you never changed your urgency message. So any job thoughts that you might have had, that's what they would have got if they called you up and you didn't answer.
To return the call, press 6.